We're going to start by celebrating American Hymnody. You know, this is a traditional program, and it celebrates American history because it is the 4th of July. And what you're hearing now is some of the first music to come to this country with the Pilgrims and Puritans. A famous song, of course, "Praise God from whom all blessings flow."
May be our joyful sounding noise unto Jehovah on the earth. Send ye to hold home with gladness, before his presence come with mirth.
The song you just heard, thank you, is known as the Old Hundredth. As I say, we know it probably more familiar with as the offering of the you sing it actually at the table too, "Praise God from whom all blessings flow," but it's the most famous hymn out of the church in New England, and it's called the 100th Psalm. The words you heard were the beginning of the 100th Psalm text. It was about 1721 when we had the first published composition in the United States. This probably is the first original published composition, and it was a setting of the 100th Psalm. The words were slightly different, but it's still the 100th Psalm, and it was called, since it was the new form of it, it was called Psalm 100 New. A very rhythmic and an energetic piece. We're going to feature soloists Steve Rayford and Rosalind Reese.
With one consent, let all the earth to God their cheerful voices raise, let homage pay with awful mirth, and sing before him songs of praise.
With one consent, let all the earth to God their cheerful voices raise, let homage pay with awful mirth, and sing before him songs of praise.
Convinced that he is God alone, from whom both we and all proceed, with whom he chooses for his own, the flock that he vouchsafes to feed.
Convinced that he is God alone, from whom both we and all proceed, with whom he chooses for his own, the flock that he vouchsafes to feed.
Sing his perfect heart.
Thank you. Our soloists were Rosalind Reese, April Lindewald, Drew Martin, and Walter Richardson. Our program was titled American Panorama, but we're actually going on two directions. First of all, we wanted to give you some hymn singing because that is truly the most American tradition we have. The early societies were very much tied around the church and around church singing. But of course, the tradition today is the American musical theater. So what we thought we'd do is now go back in time to the American Revolution. We have to, since it is, of course, 4th of July, and let you get a taste of what the music hall was like during those times. Music wasn't great, but there's some charming things, such as this song sung by April Lindewald with the women's chorus. It's called The Mischievous Bee.
Little Cupid one day o'er a myrtle bough strayed, and among the sweet blossoms he wantonly played. Plucking many a leaf from the buds of the tree, he felt that his finger was stung by a bee. He felt that his finger was stung by a bee. Little Cupid then whimpered, he sobbed and he sighed, then ran to his mother and pettishly cried, "Oh, Venus, dear mother, I'm wounded, you see, and I ask for revenge on the mischievous bee. And I ask for revenge on the mischievous bee. And I ask for revenge on the mischievous bee. I ask for revenge on the mischievous bee. And I ask for revenge on the mischievous bee. And I ask for revenge on the mischievous bee." His mother then laughed at the story he told. On his forehead of snow stroked his ringlets of gold. "Now when you wound another, my lad," answered she, "ere your arrows are pointed, you'll think on the bee. Ere your arrows are pointed, you'll think on that bee. A lesson of love let the story impart, when the beam of the eye fans the flame of the heart. Ye fair ones, remember well, yet you are free. The rose holds the fawn and the myrtle the bee. The rose holds the fawn and the myrtle the bee. The rose holds the fawn and the myrtle the bee. The rose holds the fawn and the myrtle the bee. The rose holds the fawn and the myrtle.